Dr. Hardy, Lois got a call saying that Ned Ashton has been brought in.
Yes, he's here.
Oh, he is here. I thought it was a mistake. Is he all right?
Okay, this is his wife.
Yes, I remember.
He's not dead, is he?
I'm very happy to say he's very much alive.
Okay.
It's okay. It's breathing through your nose. It's all right.
Should we be concerned?
No. She's just trying not to hyperventilate. Can you please explain to me about Ned? They said that he was in a car accident.
Well, he suffered a head injury. But Tony Jones is with him now. He's the best neurosurgeon we have.
Neurosurgeon? Oh, Miami, he needs a neurosurgeon. He's going to be brain damaged.
No breaks. No fractures. And with the exception of the mild abrasion on your forehead, I don't see any other injuries here. You want to tell me how this accident happened again?
Well, I'm not really sure. I was very upset.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember realizing how fast I was driving. I missed a curve in the road. Hit my brakes, and then I saw this tree. And that's it. My head is hurting. Something fierce.
I can't prescribe any pain medication right now. It might mask the symptoms of something that's not evident.
All right, well, I'll just have to grin and bear it, I guess.
Yeah.
But I would like to get some sleep.
Oh, I can't do that either. We've got to run some other tests on you.
What is this place, the torture chamber?
Yeah. It's one of the best, actually, and you're going to be staying overnight, so you'll get to see for yourself.
Is that really necessary?
Oh, yeah. We got to keep an eye on you.
Would you like some water?
Oh, yes. Very much. Thank you, Amy. You're a true angel of mercy.
Oh, that's what they all say when they're lying flat on their back, helpless.
Mm-hmm. I think I'll start the paperwork.
Oh, Doc. Thank you.
Oh, I think you better thank the guy upstairs. You're very lucky.
He's gonna die, huh?
And Ned's condition.
I can take it. No, I can take it. I'm a very, very strong person. The one thing I can't handle is being lied to or mollycoddled. So whatever the truth is, you just give it to
Lois. Straight. Lois. Just let him get a word in. Okay?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. By all means, speak.
Thank you. Ned's gonna be fine. We're gonna keep him overnight for observation, but I don't anticipate any complications.
You don't? That's great. He's fine.
Just barely a scratch on him.
Why did he end up in emergency?
Well, he said that he was upset and he was driving too fast. He missed a turn, ran into a tree.
What are the extent of his injuries, Tony?
A mild contusion to his forehead.
That's it?
That's it.
That's amazing.
Wait a sec. Let me get this straight. He runs face first into a tree and all he gets is a bruise on the head? Isn't that unusual?
Well, he had his seatbelt on, and so I think I would describe it more as remarkable.
Any signs of laryngitis?
Excuse me?
It's not relevant.
If he's okay, then why do you have to keep him overnight?
Well, he was unconscious when he was brought in, so there's a slight possibility he might have a concussion, but the x-rays seem fine, and I haven't seen any neurological changes, so I anticipate a full recovery.
Oh, that's great. Isn't that great?
Yeah, sure. Who found him?
Someone saw his car run off the road and called 911.
Can we go see him?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to start his paperwork right now.
Thanks.
Oh, thank you. You've been most informative.
Great. Oh, and thank you. You've been a very calming influence.
Well, I'm glad everything worked out, ladies. Excuse me.
Okay. Let's go.
I'll be outside.
Okay, fine. Ned? You hear me?
Lois. Love. Oh, like I ran my car into a tree.
I know. Listen, Tony Jones says that you're going to be okay, so just try not to worry.
I need Lois. I have to try to explain it to her.
It's okay. Don't get yourself all worked up.
No, I have to make her understand. She's all that matters to me. She's more important than life itself. Please, Brenda, I know I have no right to ask you for anything anymore. But could you just call her and just tell her?
To me, it's okay. She's already here.
Here?
Yes, she's here.
Didn't think you'd come.
Hospital called and told me you were brought into emergency. What did you think? I was going to roll over, go back to sleep?
Well, I didn't know. Considering everything, you know.
How did this happen?
Well, I'm still trying to piece it together. I was so depressed. You know, about us.
Go on. I'm listening.
Well, obviously, I wasn't thinking very clearly. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been driving so recklessly. Especially on a dark, unfamiliar country road.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. What were you doing out in the middle of nowhere, all by yourself?
Well, after I saw you this afternoon, all I wanted to do was just get away. Not just out of town. I wanted out of my own skin. I couldn't stand being it anymore. With you being so indifferent to me. So I just got in my car. And I started to drive. As fast and as far as I could. Felt a little better, so I just drove a little faster.
And it never occurred to you that you might kill yourself? Or, God forbid, somebody else?
No. No. Shame to say it. No. All I know is the fact that you didn't want me anymore. And I realized, in a split second of clarity, that without you, my life was meaningless. And that must have been when the accident happened. Because everything after that was just blank. Oh. Oh. Thank you.
What kind of an idiot do you think I am? Huh?
I can't believe you did that.
Yeah, well, you are lucky that the closest thing by you is water. You imposter. You liar. Don't you ever get enough with the lies?
So I told a couple of lies. Big deal.
A couple? Your whole life. Our whole life is just one big lie. And then you fake some accident to get my attention. Oh, Ashton, how low do you go?
Well, what was I supposed to do? All right, you're too stubborn to listen to reason. You say you want the truth, all right? Well, I try to give it to you, but you won't listen. You won't accept my apologies. You won't make any effort to understand why I did what I did.
Hold the phone. Buster, do you... You attempting to try and make this all my fault?
Uh-huh, it is your fault. You left me no choice. I had to do something big to try to penetrate that stubbornness of yours?
Stop it! Stop it before I start screaming. It is enough already. What are you? Are you crazy? You rammed yourself into a tree. Why? I do not know why. You know, because this is just right up there with your attack of laryngitis, which was yet another attempt to make a fool out of me. Well, no more, Ashton. You could wrap yourself around an entire forest for all I care, because
Lois,
as far as I'm concerned, not only are we over, we are over!
Lois, please, Lois!
This is a hospital. What is going on here?
Nothing.
listen to me.
Ned, what's the meaning?
I love you. That's the truth. That is the only truth.
You wouldn't recognize the truth if it knocked on your front door with a letter of introduction.
Lois, you have to stop pretending we don't love each other.
Ooh, you speak for yourself, Buster. I could never love such a duplicitous person as you. What you did to me tonight, Ashton, it was cruel. You had me believing you were just this side of death's door. Look at you. Look at you. You are as healthy as an ox. I'm saying it. For the very last time, you stay out of my life.
Lois.
Brenda,
Lois.
You coming or you
Lois,
going?
You can't.
How could you, Ned?
It was misguided,
Shut up,
I know.
You are a stupid, disgusting, sickening pig.
Lois! Lois!
Steve. This is... It's a long story.
Really?
Where do
Spare
I...
Spare me
where
the details. Just be grateful I'm indebted to your family for the many contributions they've made to this hospital. But we're not here to promote your personal life, Ned. This is not a stage where you can feel free to perform. We have patients here who are sick and hurt. For you to use our hospital staff to enhance your romantic life is unscrupulous. Now get in there and get dressed and get out of my hospital before I end up calling the police.
Well, you gotta love his determination.